great, son. It's great to have you here with me, you know. I'm glad I got you in a Staten Island Community College. It was a beautiful thing, you know. Your father loves you, you know. Never lose sight of that. And, you know, I really care about you and, you know, getting right and meeting Julio and doing all the neat things you need to do. And that's why I'm bringing you here, where it all started. I used to come here as a young kid, you know, back when they didn't let Moulinans in, and you could drink all the beer you wanted in a glass bottle, and if a motherfucker talked funny to your wife, you could slash him across your face. And you know what they would do? They would fucking laugh. And you know, the seventh inning stretch was just a fucking shot of J-Mo with the god Mickey Mantle. Those were the days. Now we got a bunch of fucking Dominicans and fucking Moulinans and shit like that. But you know, it's still the thought that counts. You know, it's the team. So that's why there's no names on the goddamn jersey. Isn't that right, son? Oh, fuck, Dad. I didn't even know he dragged me out of the basement. My fucking guts hurt. Fuck. What is this, bonding? I want to bother my works, bro. Give me my fucking works. You got my works on you, bro?
No, son. No. You know, as I say when I stop and frisk poor unsuspecting people of color, do you have anything sharp? Do you have anything that's going to stick me? So I would not travel with that type of equipment. I apologize. All right? Just turn the beer bottle cap sideways and stab yourself in the arm, you jerk off. Here we go. Hey, first pitch. Let's go. Hey, hey, Maron. Let's go. Yay. All right. Hey, pal. Hey, where Terrell, Tyrone, whatever your name is, Jamal, Jamel. Hey, listen here. Hey, toss me a bag of nuts. Hey, toss me a bag of nuts, you fucking, you know what? And let me get a couple beers. Oh, there's a limit. Well, you know what? Go fuck yourself. You know what I mean? I'm out of here. Fuck this shit. I'm a Mets fan now. Do the fucking drop.
Episode 153.
Yeah.
Bodega Boys in the building. Live from Milk Studios, sponsored by Cash App.
Yeah.
Happening opening day, boy bags.
You know what I'm saying? We started it with what?
A win. You know what it is.
A W, nigga.
A win.
The Yankees is always on top of the fucking league, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
You know who didn't win?
Should I guess? Can I get some guesses?
You know, just
you know what I'm saying?
Waking up and just Bill Simmons looking in the mirror like,
yeah,
let's just end it.
Wow.
Can't do 162 games of this.
But we have the highest payroll in baseball. How's this happening?
Sad.
Oh my god.
That's right.
Fuck out
Red Sox lost.
So got dicks. They go, we blanked them.
I just want to point out though that the Red Sox lost opening day last year and won the whole thing. So,
I mean, yeah. But fuck it. You know
fuck
what I'm
it. But it's a new energy to
that's
the Yankees.
Right. That's right.
They're young. I feel like this is the year. 28.
That's right.
Ooh, 28 rings would be great for the culture.
CC,
could you understand how much dickheads we would be? Our show would just be a half an hour of just Yankee clips.
That's it. Yankee highlights.
That's all it is.
Of games that mean nothing.
Just us watching Luke Voit eat sunflower seeds, crack it up.
It's interleague play. The Mets are 38 games under 500, and
yeah,
they're facing the Yankees, who have somehow 289 wins.
Well, your boy, Robinson Cano, he homered yesterday.
Try to.
Because he's back in Queens.
Back in New York.
Back in New York.
Yeah, kind of.
Near uptown. You know, back on
shout
the hookah.
Queens. No Queenslander. Shout out to Queens on the mall. You know what I'm saying?
No Queenslander. Everyone loves Queens. Shout out to Cop Killer Queens.
You know what I'm saying?
We're no longer allowed to call it that. You know, that name is
yes,
no longer PC.
A little problematic.
But, you know, shout out to Jamaica. Shout out to Guy R. Brewer.
You know what I'm saying?
The Van Wyck. Constant traffic. You know what it is. Shout out to the air train.
Shout out to, yo, 152. Nigga Franny Lou. What?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? What? I left rag is high rag. It's really not at all.
Well, back in the day, it probably was.
I mean,
but
probably less sand.
Yeah. Well, Nori has never been to Iraq, so
he's going by what reference.
He's going by
imagine Nori reading a National Geographic, nigga reading about Iraq, like, oh, sand dudes. Oh wow.
Then he just turns to the picture of the African people with the titties out, like,
oh yo, niggas got titties. Whoa, whoa,
yo, look at the jugs. Look at the jugs.
Oh shit, look at the jugs, nigga. What? Yeah, I'm gonna fill a jug full of mug, nigga. What?
Do you remember didn't 50 Cent have a game called Blood in the Sand?
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
It was literally just a third-person shooter with 50 and 28 on Lloyd Banks.
Why can't we make that?
Why is that not the most popping video game ever, bro?
Let's remake Contra.
Like, with just us two. Just us two.
Mad muscled.
Mad brolic with tank tops on.
With big old guns.
Spread shot. Nigga just shooting three tennis balls at the same time.
Those guns made no sense.
None.
There was too much chance for a friendly fire.
You know what I'm saying?
We have no fucking space suits on and we're fighting aliens?
And aliens in outer space who do have space suits, by the way.
to protect them. I don't understand. The laser was just like a big ass red crayon that came out of your gun and killed everything in sight.
And they were just like, yo, here's 30 lives. If you got to give someone 30 lives, the game is too fucking hard.
Oh, fam.
Right?
Come on. The end level, nigga, where you just be shooting the heart, you're like, I got this, nigga. And then, man, spiders start coming out the shit. Like, come on, man.
They used to, was that Capcom or who? Temco?
Konami.
Konami. Because that, Gradius, like, all those games were dumb. Games, like, they start easy and then they get stupid hard.
They literally get impossible.
And now, like, I go back and play them now and I'm like, yo, I can't do this as an adult.
Like,
what was Young Jesus doing?
You feel me? Like, fam. There's games that, like, I feel like they were just, like, got lazy towards the end, and they were like, yo, we don't got to end into this shit, so just make level 8 dumb hard and impossible.
I think that was Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, because, remember, like, a lot of people never went past when you get to Vegas and flight school, and then the game basically resets, and you have to go back to his home, but it's, like, a riot, and cars are, like, blowing up and all this stuff. You can see it's, like, it seems like a programming glitch, and, like, the storyline just went nowhere, but I fucked with it.
You know what I'm saying?
Listen. I was like, oh, go, this is what we're doing now?
Yeah, right. Fuck it. I guess it is what it is. I was going to come back and blow up cars anyway.
I mean, that's what you. No one was really playing Grand Theft Auto for the story.
No,
you were just playing that shit to run niggas over
run real niggas quick
after
over
a bad
shit.
Day at work.
Carjack niggas and just shit.
Shoot like, up the block, chase a pedestrian for 5 blocks and punch him in the back of their head.
You see, like three niggas having fun talking and shit. You just come like, out of nowhere, like, bah, 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 bah. What up? Fuck your day, nigga. Niggas start scattering.
The worst is when you go, when you purposely are like playing the game, waiting for the cops. Like,
yeah.
What's up?
Yeah, nigga. What's up? I'm gonna steal this car right here in front of you.
In front of you, I don't give a shit.
I don't give a fuck.
Are you gonna punch a cop? In the game?
What? Yeah, nigga, just standing there like in the corner, like directing traffic. You're like, hold that. You fucking
get the lights. You. The problem with Grand Theft Auto is like every now when you get actually pulled over by the cops, you be like, I could pull over. How fast is this car?
You know what I'm saying?
Then you remember you like in a Camry and shit.
The
like,
best to do though is to let them pull you over and try to get you out the whip and then just gun it as soon as they try to open the door and just drag the nigga for like 8 blocks and he falls off.
In the game. All right.
Do not try that at an actual traffic stop.
Nothing but respect for our first responders.
That's
Blue Lives Matter. I wish you people would stop resisting arrest.
Please stop.
You know?
You know what I'm saying? Listen, also, reaching in your pocket for ID is a form of resisting. So just like, I don't know, be like, yo, it's in my pocket. Can you
I've never reached about, like, literally, cops would get annoyed when they stopped the frisbee because I'm on some scarecrow shit.
Yeah.
I'm not moving. Yeah, you going in the pockets, my guy. Fam, like, I'm not trying to get.
You Medusa me, my nigga. Like, it's quiet.
I'm a possum now. Nowhere. I'm like, plane dead.
You won't find that tray bag in my butt, nigga? You're going to have to go get it.
Nigga, she's in the holding cell and the corners are getting pointy.
Damn, this nigga really have to staple this shit? Damn, I thought we was peoples.
Okay, when I'm going to see the judge?
Shout out to all the niggas hitting you with packs and they staple the bags or they burn them. It's like, bro, you really don't fuck with me, nigga. Like you have zero trust in me.
Wow. I mean, get a vacuum sealer, guys.
You know what I'm saying? Come on. It's 2019, bro. You don't got to sit there with a lighter all night.
How come no one set up a big drug distribution network using drones yet?
That is a great question.
Yeah.
I mean, like, you
can, I mean, if my weed guy, like, if you, I know you listen, go get some drones. You don't have to drive out.
Yeah, fam. Come on, B. You know what I'm saying? You got.
And they can't track it back to you. Like, they drone technology, unless you write your phone number or some sign.
It's some dumb shit. Yeah, bro. And you got the app on your phone. You see where this shit is going. Like,
but see, now it's not reverse because I can't be like, yo, I'm going to send a drone to your house to get this weed. They're like, nigga, you thought.
You thought.
You see the drone come in, it's like. I think you shot my drone.
You're like, yo, I'm gonna send it with a drone. Your man's like,
shut up, my nigga, shut up.
Yo, just get in your camera, nigga. Like, stop fucking playing with me.
Yo, Poppy, just send me the GPS for your house. Send this drone to your location.
Yo, oh my god. Nah, I'm not taking weed from a drone, by the way. Like, I understand the convenience
you'll
of
take
it,
You'll take weed from the butthole of a young Latino driving a Honda CRX?
Old Mero would. Mm-hmm. Now, new Mero's on
new
some,
Mero?
Like...
Yeah, dispensary
some,
Mero?
Dispensary Mero, you feel me? Like, we on some, like, yo, we get California weed and shit. Like, California. Niggas send the shit in the mail. It feels totally legal.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, if I pick up a pile of packages off my fucking front steps, nigga, and it's like, sneakers, kids' clothes... fucking blanket, weed,
yeah,
you know, DVD, you yeah know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, nigga, this shit is legal.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, this shit came with my novel, nigga. Like, like, come on, give me a break. It's fucking weed, nigga, damn. This shit's about to be legal in Jersey in like fucking 3 days.
Is it? I thought they said no.
They said no, and then the governor was like, nah, fuck that, nigga. This is my shit. This is my Obamacare, nigga. I'm legalizing weed in Jersey. Fuck y'all. And everybody's like, all right, cool. Except for, like, the, like, weird southern part of Jersey that's, like, connected to PA. And they were, like, wild rednecky.
I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, why wouldn't you want weed?
Why wouldn't you want weed? Even the MAGA niggas, like, the prosciutto smoke weed and shit. Like, I was mad surprised. I was like, oh, you niggas smoke weed, too? He's like, yeah, bro, you smoke a little pot, you know? You do fucking coke all night. What the fuck you gonna do? You do smoke a little pot, you know, before you go to bed so you can sleep.
But they smoke like roaches. They smoke like joints. J's.
They smoke J's.
They smoke J's.
With the little filter.
All right, they're not smoking baby dicks like you me. All right? I'm out here smoking unicorn corn. You know what I'm unicorn saying? Horns.
Ah, nigga. My shit look like a fucking Fred Flintstones club, nigga, when I all like right this shit.
Like, you see me with a zebra toenail in my mouth. Like, yeah. Do zebras have toenails? No, they have hooves.
Yeah.
Do people eat zebra?
We should slut that shit. There's mad zebras out there. Every time I see on TV, like, and in every baby book, it's like zebra. You know what I'm saying?
Is zebra meat good?
Or if you're fucking Peppa Pig, you say zebra, which is completely fucking incorrect, B.
Zebra.
It's a Z, nigga. The fuck is a Z, nigga? Is that an alien life form? Zed, fuck out of here, nigga.
ZZ top.
Zed. Yeah, right? ZZ top. That shit got no swag whatsoever, bro. You might as well cut your fucking beards off, man, and just play one guitar at a time.
They say that zebra is sweeter than beef. We gotta start a Shake Shack that's just zebra meat.
Zebra meat?
Just straight zebra
meat. That's the secret?
$28 burger. People will pay that. People will pay that. Woo!
I was gonna say Eddie Murphy in Madagascar, but I think it was Chris Rock.
I've never seen Madagascar.
That shit has 80 million parts, bro.
I could see that. Like, we'll be in it soon.
Yeah, of course. You know, see, it would be like the Bronx rats that somehow escaped onto a ship.
It's like that movie Zootopia.
Oh, yeah.
I thought I saw that, but I forgot. I saw it on a plane from Antigua, and the plane was mad Yankee janky. And it had drop-down monitors.
Oh, okay.
So we all had to watch, but they didn't tell. There was, like, no headphones or anything.
Oh,
so
you had to guess?
Yeah.
You had to lip read?
I had to guess read to guess what was going on, and apparently the movie's about, like, race and shit.
Yeah.
Because I saw it the other day, and I was like, oh, wow, this shit is deep as fuck.
Yeah.
I thought it was about, like, women, animals or some shit.
It's like kids are going to see this shit and be like, yeah, animals. And then you're like, oh,
it's about
shit,
like power plays and racial aspects and politics. Because
the predators are like the black people, and the prey are like the white people. You know what I'm saying? And then they play those dynamics throughout the movie and shit. It's a lot. If it's you a eat lot. A lot of edibles and take your kid to go watch it, it is a lot. Trust damn. Me. I was just like, damn, nigga. I was like, did James Baldwin write this? Like,
this shit is some Harlem Renaissance shit.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, nigga, shit.
He's like inspired by Richard Wright. You're like, damn.
Damn.
Shit, bro. Dark as fuck.
Okay.
To see a lion like, we can't live like this.
We was kings.
Whatever happens to a raisin in the sun. Rawr.
Rawr, nigga.
A lion king in Harlem.
Yo.
You want that? You want me to write that? Remember, I'm an English major. Yeah, that shit wild depressing.
I'm liking all of
Simba. Simba. The baby's not breathing. Damn.
Oprah definitely financed that shit.
Oh, she'll finance the hell out of it. That should be like, and I gotta be in it.
And Lee Daniels will be like, yo, let me hold something, baby. Hey, what's up, baby?
Not with your hair like that, Lee. Not giving no money to a nigga with a half perm. Nigga was doing the perm and then like fell asleep with the timer.
Yo. Oh, man, that shit's crazy. We were talking about niggas getting canceled earlier, yo. Like, is Dana Susan canceled?
No.
No? Is he canceled?
Nope.
He's not canceled.
Because most people don't even know who he is.
That's what I'm saying. I'm like, well, how could you get canceled? Niggas like, gotta find out who you are to then cancel you? Like, that's a lot of work.
Yeah.
Like, fam. Like, what's for me to quote-unquote cancel somebody, I gotta know who you are.
It's such a weird thing, because if you think about it, it sounds like some white valley girl thing. It's like, that's canceled.
That's totally canceled. Like,
okay, what does that mean?
Well, okay, so now what?
Okay.
You gonna put the t-shirt down?
It's funny, 21? Like, if they said canceled and like, oh, your checks disappear.
Like oh shit.
Oh, wow, your car disappears.
Oh, my God.
Your chains. You're like,
poo. You wake up in a white room and underwear.
Oh, no. It's like the end of Avengers when they snap the face. I was like, Mero, you got canceled.
Oh, my God.
I read for you, you turn to dust.
See?
Mm-hmm.
See? We writing an episode of Black Mirror, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming. We can't when you get it's the title of the episode obviously is canceled.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And you get canceled for saying problematic and you wake up and your life is nothing.
But two people cancel each other at the same time.
Oh.
Now they're just in the white room together.
Like, you canceled me?
I canceled you.
How?
I canceled you first.
How we both
canceled? They got to go into the council. The cancel council.
Cancel council?
And they have to prove who is more due for canceling.
It's whoever has the wokest bio on Twitter.
And they have to. But because it's like in this area of cancellation, you're allowed to have any person ever in the history, because it's outside of the realm of time and space. True. So you could get like Abraham Lincoln to defend you, yeah. Nelson Mandela, Hitler.
Oh, wow. Shit.
Can't get canceled if you got Hitler as your lawyer.
You feel me?
What if Hitler is a great lawyer?
Wow.
Because it's cancel world, baby. You know what I'm saying? Everything's upside down. Dogs marrying cats. It's niggas wild. Is wearing Adidas pants with you Nikes. It's wild.
Nigga finesse half Europe. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Like,
he did.
You feel me?
Like, not for nothing, they're going to look back at what Putin did the same way they looked at Hitler. Because
oh, yeah.
Putin got us with a wow April Fool's Day
all
joke.
Day, all yo, day.
That nigga cooked us.
He was like, yo,
shout out to you, Putin.
He's like, my nigga, look at this. Give me my gill. Hold that. I gave him a gill. It is an American thing, but it's Russian now because I take over America. Thank you.
He's got to look at every time. He's got to crack up every time he sees Trump.
Bruh. That nigga probably watch Fox News like it's like, Comic View. Nigga.
That nigga be smoking the wild like, J. Like, yo, yo, I did that.
Nigga, like. Nigga just looking at Twitter moments like.
They give him the phone. They be like, sir, it's the president of the United States. He be like, yo, Vladimir. Is that nigga again?
Yo, who this?
Yo.
Hello. Who is this on the line, please?
Yeah, gotta speak to Vladimir Putin. It's your boy, Trumpito.
Who?
Trumpito. What up, who? Vlad?
Who?
What up, Vlad?
I'm not going to even talk. I'm going to use the soundboard on your ass.
Oh, man. Sad. Yeah. Like, was the Dominican people there? Because Trump just met with, like, I was going to say the King of Jamaica. That's not what
he told. The King of Jamaica? Yo, King of the Dance Hall.
He just met with Beanie Man.
Yo, well, I feel like, yo, but you know what's wild, though? I feel like celebrities in other countries would actually be good presidents as opposed to Trump. Like, I feel like American celebrities are wild dumb.
Okay, so listen. Shout out to Antigua, because Antigua is a real nigga nation.
Okay, shout out.
Because the Bahamas, Dominican Republic, Haiti, Jamaica, and St. Lucia all met with Donald Trump.
Who? Read that back? Antigua was like, nah, fuck that.
Antigua was like, nah, fuck that. Y'all niggas is weak-minded. Oh. He said the weak-minded regional leaders.
Oh.
So shout out to Antigua.
Yo.
I will remember that when I come and take your island over to start my coup.
Yo, fucking Dion. Yo, my nigga. Yo, listen. That nigga, you better have given that nigga poison Bustelo or some shit. Mm-hmm.
And Dominican Republic is not even a member of CARICOM. So, like, DR, get your shit together. Like, force them. Look at them niggas wasn't even wearing good suits. Come on, man.
Nah, they fucking up. Who all in there?
It's the head of... It's St. Lucia, Haiti, the Bahamas, and DR and Jamaica. Boo.
Boo, damn. Y'all
Prime
up.
Minister Andrew Holness, what did it do?
Yo. Danilo, papi.
Okay. Shout out to the Prime Minister of Antigua and Barbuda. Gaston Brown. Sounds like a made up name, but that's his actual name. Fucks with you. Gaston, when I come back to Antigua, let me hold something.
Let me hold something down. You know what I'm saying?
Let me hold something.
We rock with you, B. You know what I'm saying?
I would go back to Carnival, but a lot of people don't realize Carnival is just the same song over and over for like 20 hours.
Sorry to disappoint y'all. Listen, but you're gonna be so fucked up, you're not even gonna care. It's gonna be like Baby Shark, nigga. You're gonna love it.
You'll go through that phase where you're like, what is this song? Then you'll be like,
Sexo.
That was a great song.
Bring me a lap selector. Bring it back one time.
Oh, man.
Big up Trinidad. Big up Antigua. Big up all of the West Indies.
Can't find that shit, bro. What was it?
Sexo. I feel like you just throwing Sexo Calypso. That should have. Is that what you did?
It was
Sexo Soca? I don't know. What was the fucking genre?
Carnival. It was Carnival, you know.
You know what I'm talking about? Hey! Sexo. Hey! Yeah! Fight up! Hey.
Yes, remember, Sexo Sexto. The original carnival song of Bodega Boys. See, this is the part when I was like, okay, this song is a lot, but then this part right here was like, I was like, okay.
Okay. Oh.
And you're like, oh, all right, this is annoying. Is this just repeating words? And it was like, all right, we about to switch it up on you.
Oh, check it out. You ready? You ready? Wheel up, Saleta! Wagwan! Oh my god! Wagwan!
Wow!
Wow! All of the big yeah! All of the big goddamn! All of the big goddamn!
I forgot what a big tune that was.
Big just, tune, my tune!
All of a sudden, I'm just transported back to 3 a.m. flying down a dark road with no headlights.
The only sound effect the DJ got is a fucking laser. The fucking dance hall laser. Transformers.
Nah, because the truck that was playing this, they had like a live band playing it or some shit. And I was like, wow. And they were jamming. And they were taking like drum solos and shit.
Shout out to y'all,
the whole time I was just like, hey guys, this is not safe at all.
You know what I'm saying?
At all. There's a guy with an oven mitt pushing up a power cord. Facts. Like that's not how life is supposed to be.
Those are real heroes, B. You know what I'm saying? All my carnival musicians, you know what I'm saying?
The real heroes of carnival are the old ladies that sell you the bun and cheese. Cause you be ready to pass the fuck out. And you see that bun and cheese, that should be glistening, my nigga. You look at your watch, you're like, I've been dancing since 3 a.m.
Yo, shout out to homie that sold me the coconut on the side of the road the last time I was in Carnival, my nigga. You saved my life. And that is not an understatement. I'm like, I'm supposed to drink water eventually, right? No,
I don't think I drank water the whole time I was there. All I drank was rosé and Beck's. It was like, my kidney was like, yo, are y'all serious? My kidney would just close the door. It was like, nah, we doing Brexit. Yeah. This nigga wildin'. They was like, you're not even gonna even try?
Yeah.
It was like, yo, for God's sakes, drink the pool water. I was like, nah.
I knew something was up when I got them. My uncle picked me up at the airport. He's mad brolic, but his pot belly is like fucking, nigga looks like 12 and a half months pregnant. I'm like, that's a Jack Daniels belly, my G.
Oh my god.
And he jumped in the car and just cracked open the bottle of Jack. I'm like, yo, you can't do that. Nigga's drinking and driving. He's like,
nah, they don't got no drinking and driving down there.
Nigga laughed at my
You'd have face. To like crash into like the prime minister's house
and
get charged with drinking and driving.
You have to crash into his house and not offer him a drink.
Yeah.
If you crash into his house,
you gotta crash into his house while he's in the living room and make him spill his drink. You get like the death penalty or some shit. Shit's crazy.
Yo, shit is bananas. Yo, the Knicks are mathematically eliminated from playoffs.
The Knicks have been mathematically eliminated before the game season started. But
listen, we coming back.
I thought that was my stomach. I was like, damn, I should have told Victoria, don't bake an egg and cheese this morning. It's like, oh, man.
I forgot my lactate.
Oh, man. Yo, fam, I took lactate yesterday because I went to Chipotle, had half a Chipotle bowl. And my stomach was like, yo, fam, are you wilding?
Fam.
There was like, in your big age, you don't know you're lactose intolerant?
Dog.
Stomach came out and beat me with a slap. Oh, man.
I did a triple. I ate a cheese dog, a cheese hot dog.
Oof.
With cheese fries, like sloppy Joe cheese fries. With like cheese sauce, sloppy
half
Joe.
Half of me is like, why would you do that? Mexican and the cheese. Other half of me is like, I know exactly why.
Yeah, exactly why.
Yeah, you'd be on Seamless and be like, French fries. Oh, you want cheese fries?
Yeah.
And then you have the bad
additional options.
You got the devil on your shoulder, like, do it, nigga.
Do it, nigga. Fuck, nigga. Your pancreas is ass.
And on your right side, where your angel should be, there's nobody.
That nigga's in the bathroom, like, yo, what are y'all talking about?
The devil's like, nah, kill that nigga. Or them cheese fries. cheese fries are great.
Oh, they're delicious.
Until it's time to return the sender, and then it's just like, wow. Wow.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
A little bit of water from the toilet splashes up on your butthole and makes the sizzling noise like butthole be feeling like a Mike Castle's grill. You ever be too weak to grab toilet paper? You just be like,
no.
Looking like Jordan at the end of the food game. Nigga, if you take a shit and you sweating, Yeah, you gotta change your diet.
Serious, bro.
Yeah, you think getting naked's gonna help?
Yeah.
You eat all that cheese and shit. You taking off clothes and shit? You're like,
no. Turn on the cold water in the shower?
Yeah.
Like, I'm jumping right in this shit as soon as I'm done.
Yo. Just sitting there like, oh, I think I'm done.
Yeah.
But it feels like this is war.
Yeah, your butthole's like,
stupid. I'm not gonna let you get the chance.
Nigga, we here. We here for 2 hours, nigga. Focus up. You know what I'm saying? We get ready.
Or worse, when you just like, I gotta take a regular shit. Then you get there and your butt be like, what? Yo.
I'm like, how did she get on the back of the ball?
You're like, yo.
What the fuck?
Physics, it don't even work. Like, the fuck? I gotta wipe my front now? Yo.
That's big facts, bro.
Yo.
Oh my god.
Did you do you have not a squatty, well, they have a squatty
body. The squatty body, yeah.
I have a bamboo one.
I'm mad fucking finagle bagel guy, yeah. So I just use the stool, my step stool as a squatty body.
The actual one, change it, yo. You be feeling like an intellectual. You be like with your legs up in the air, like, yeah,
like, yeah, like the thinker.
Yeah. Like, at first you feel dumb, and you know, like, if you don't, you gotta practice so you don't wanna fall off. Nothing worse to fall off the toilet while you taking a shit.
Oh no.
You fall off down the shit on the side of the toilet. Like
on your thigh, nigga.
It's on the bathroom rug. It's on your head. You gotta like grab the paper towel without getting Like, wow, this is a doodle talk.
This is quite embarrassing.
It's a doodle talk. Do you know the New York City law? If you have a dog, you're not allowed to like pick up its scoop and throw the garbage in a regular trash bag.
You guys take it home and throw it in your trash?
You're supposed to take it home and flush it.
What? But it's in a plastic bag.
Well, I mean, when they made the law, it was probably like 1800 and there was like two dogs.
Like, I know that you're not supposed to.
Who the fuck is? No, okay, listen, I love dogs. Ain't nobody I'm not walking my dog and taking a litter back and flushing it. Like,
you're
he's
wilding.
Not human.
You're not wilding. You're fuck not wilding. We have a dog. We walk 10 blocks.
My new shit is they're building like the wild gentrification building on the top of the end of my block. So what I do is I bag up the dog shit and I roof it.
Yeah, you gotta roof it. Yeah.
So yeah, shout out to those construction workers. They're like, what is this?
Yo, if you ever picked up mad bags of shit off the Cross Bronx, it was you, boy.
Just tossing them.
I'm trying to test my arm strength with these shits. Like, yo, how fucking I get this shit? I'm trying to hit 18 wheelers and shit.
No, they got all these like pick up after your dog boxes in my neighborhood. I was like, keeping it clean. And niggas do not use it. And some of y'all got big ass dogs, and we know it's your dog.
Yo, that's why I want to fucking shout out to sanitation department, because you know those are the niggas that gotta empty those boxes at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
A box full of dog shit, nigga.
Yeah, sanitation. Damn. I guess if you get used to it, it's cool. Like, it's a good job, great benefits. Get paid.
Retired dumb early.
But that first time, some of that garbage water splashing into your mouth. Hey, Martinez, look out, I'm throwing a dress. And you're like, what? And it's like, slow motion. It's like,
no,
in your mouth.
No.
A full cup of it. Like, yeah.
You swallow this shit too? Like, oh, no.
Because I remember when my father was a landlord, I'd have to sort people's garbage. Because if you don't sort the garbage, if you put cans in the regular garbage, you get like the wild ticket. Mm-hmm. So I'd have to go through the garbage for an eight family apartment building. And the first thing I noticed, everyone cooks rice. I don't know what the fuck that's about.
Yeah.
People love to put, they cook rice and they make too much and they put it in the garbage. With diapers. I don't know why. Why do we gotta do
this? Rice and diapers.
Rice and diapers. Now I'm going through it with my gloves looking for cans. And then one day I was like, nah, I'm not doing it. Got a $400 ticket the next day.
You know what you
gotta do? Someone put like some Goya cans.
My uncle made me do that shit too. You gotta pick up the bag and just slam it on the ground, and if I don't hear metal in that shit, I just use the throw it in the fucking thing.
You gotta open it.
Fuck that shit.
The sanitation, because I was like, why is sanitation going so hard? But apparently my father had like written some angry letter or some shit. So the sanitation worker was coming and opening the trash cans and going through the trash bags looking for cans.
Yo.
I was like, wow.
Y'all are doing a lot.
But here's the reverse. When I used to take care of my family's house, and we got a sanitation ticket, and then I was like, nah, fuck this, never happening again. Saturday morning, I up buying sneakers, and I hear the garbage truck, and I'm like, oh, shit, and I run outside to make sure, because I know the sanitation cop is coming, and there's, like, a big piece of cardboard in front of the house, and I go and pick it up, and your man gets out the house. gets out the car. I was like, oh shit, Desus, you live here? I was like, yeah, y'all niggas be giving me wild OD tickets and shit. He was like, nah, I got you, fam. Don't worry, you ain't never getting no tickets no more. I was like,
oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
so, man. Shout out to Crooked Sanitation Workers.
You know what I'm saying?
Have YouTube, I guess.
Shout out to y'all, you know what I mean?
Sounds kind of righteous to me.
Gang yeah. shit, you know what I'm saying?
You know, if any other union employees, if any firefighters or something want to give me the hookup, you know what I'm saying? Tell me the real number if my house is on fire because I don't know that 911 is a scam.
Yeah, like the direct shit to the firehouse. Mm-hmm.
It's like 914.
You know what I'm saying? Let me know when I got to put my Christmas tree out. Shit like that, you feel me? Like if I could.
Yo, my neighbor still has her Christmas tree on the balcony.
My sister still has a Christmas tree up. I mean, it's fake. It's fake.
So, but
it's
like, but I mean, you know what? Like, who's really gonna tell Ingrid what to do?
Exactly.
So
I tried. I tried.
Shout to Ingrid.
You know what I'm saying?
Shout to Ingrid, a true queen. You keep your Christmas tree up as long as you want. Okay?
I tried it. She's like, nigga, it's a decoration now. I took all the ornaments off. Like, I was just like, okay, let's go get frozen yogurt.
Oh my God. Shout out to Ingrid. When I saw her at the premiere party, she was like, nigga, you're not gonna say hi. I was like, oh wow, okay, hi. Oh, wow. Holy.
We go to get frozen yogurt, and the frozen yogurt place is right next to where she gets her eyebrows done.
How wholesome is that? Mero and his sister go get frozen yogurt.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my little sister.
Fucking telenovela.
I love you. So we go get the froyo, and then she's just like, you know what I'm saying? Out here.
The level up.
So serve, you feel me? I put gummy bears, chocolate, all that shit. I was mad smack.
Wait, aren't you? Frozen yogurt's not. You can still fuck with it if you're lactose.
I had lactate in the crib. Yeah,
that's milk in it though.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't. Oh, it's yogurt, duh.
Yeah. But then fucking, she's like, oh, I'm just getting my eyebrows done real quick, and I'm thinking it's like wax. So it's just like boom, boom, swip, 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 and we out.
Yeah.
Nah, fam.
What you got? Threading or sugar?
Dude, fucking threading, woo! Nigga. I was just there like,
wow.
Wow. Wow.
Does it look like niggas is playing the... It look like threading is basically double dutch for your eyebrows.
I'm like, so yo, for real?
Like,
I'm sitting in front of the place looking like a wild creep. All the shorties in there like, who is this nigga? She's like, that's my brother. He's waiting for me.
That's even creepier.
I was like,
that's
no.
That's even creepier.
I was like, I'm not waiting for you, nigga. Give me the keys. I'm going home.
You can't... There's got to be an age limit for doing shit with your siblings. Like, if your sibling is of another gender.
Listen, if your sibling is Ingrid, you do whatever the fuck she wants. You understand me?
She's like, do what you want when you're popping.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, but you can't, like.
I'd be like, yo, Ingrid, I don't want to do that. She'd be like. Nigga, sit the fuck down.
Wow.
You doing what I want. I'm like, okay. You got it.
I'm pussy.
Yo, hey, you ain't got to do all that.
Swivity.
You ain't got to do all that. And she hit me with the, yo, can you get me the Concords or whatever? Like, I know you be plugged in or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then she pulled up with them shits last time we hung out. And she was just like, my sneakers is dope. I was like, oh, shit, those shits are hard. She's like, yeah, nigga, I bought them.
Wow. In your face. In your face, like, how you feel?
I was just like, yo. But I sent an email. And
not good enough, nigga.
They were not available. And just... I did the right question. Like,
this nigga dying.
Yo,
damn,
son. I got you next time. Though. I got you next time. Don't worry. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, we need to design our own sneakers. Because Big Baller Brand went out of business.
They fell off.
So yeah. We coming out with Big Bodega. Let's
big
just
bodega
buy
brand.
Big. Just buy Big Baller Brand. We turn Big Bodega Brand.
Boom.
Yeah.
Logo ready. Everything
Big Bodega
ready.
Balls.
Ah.
Yeah.
You know what
we
saying?
Got three models. We got the for the hardworking dads. We got the Mero.
Yes. You know what I'm saying?
For the runners, we got the Desus.
You feel me?
And for my intellectuals, we got the V100s.
Oh,
the Vicks.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Whoa. Oh. With the real natural hair cut out in the back.
Are those gonna be hard bottoms?
The V-Lows.
Yes.
No, whoa, over there.
We are not affiliated with V-Loan. Okay, that is not us. All right. Okay, no. All right, a lot of y'all are like, but that nigga look like you, Desus. I'm like, no. But yes, the Victor shoes are basically hard bottoms, but instead of hard bottoms, they have like the Vapor Max bubbles.
Yeah.
So there's like, nice. They're like a penny loafer with that. Yeah.
I'm a Cole Haan. Yeah. I'm a Cole Haan Lunar Gram.
Yeah.
Lunar Lon Cole Haan? Lunar Haan?
My sneaker
that's
is just.
Your technology. So I'm with it.
My sneaker is just a Chelsea boot made out of foam posit. You never know if you gotta square up at brunch and shit. Like, yo, what's up?
Yo.
What's up? Drop $100 on you after I eat these eggs, nigga. But if you don't mind, I got a swag surf first.
My shit is a house shoe, nigga, with a sneaker that slips on top.
Nigga, I fear I got house shoes.
When you gotta get out the house and shit, like, oh, let me just sleep on stickers on real quick. Bye bye.
They'd be like, yo, they're the first self lacing house shoes.
Oh my God.
They're also the first house shoe someone killed somebody. Like, they're gonna arrest the Dominican mother. She's like, it was a house shoe. I threw it. The child died from blunt force trauma.
She got cleats to the bottom for no reason.
They're like, why would you put it has GPS technology to always hit the kid? Doing that shit around the corner and shit.
Oh shit, damn. Yeah, nigga. Nike homework first, then Pokemon, stupid.
Nike's gonna do the wild inspiration motivational video. They're gonna be like,
fuck them kids.
They said we was crazy. Oh, fuck them kids. It's just like, just mad mother's like, fuck them kids.
Just mad fucking.
Fuck them kids.
Bad time response and shit.
Fuck them kids.
Mad ages and shit just flashing.
Fuck them kids. Fuck them kids. Fuck them kids. Fuck them kids.
You pan out and that mad mom's like, fuck them kids.
But all the moms, when the drone zooms out,
it's just one mom?
No, it's a Michael Jordan's face. It's like the new Air Jordan 1.
Smoking a cigar.
Like, fuck all them kids.
I was like, oh, I was wondering what that circle was. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's his hoop earring. Okay. Why y'all all wearing silver?
I was like, wow, there's a lot of bootcut jeans in this. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? We out here, nigga.
Yo, Jordan still got the earring in?
Yeah, he's not giving up on that shit.
To this day.
You feel me?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
He's not. Nah, when you reach a certain amount of money as a black man, you have to get a hoop earring.
That's it.
You have to. It's the Ed Bradley rule, baby. Wait till I come in. I'm going to go full out. I'm getting two hoop earrings.
Yep.
Maybe the piercing in the nose. And the big nipples.
You just got to make sure that you don't get the one that has like the spikes on the end, because if it goes lopsided, it looks wild goofy. You got to get the full circle.
I'm getting a big circle, the X-Clan shit.
Yeah.
I want to look like a sexy bull.
Yeah.
I want to look like a black guy that if you saw me, you were like, he's either gay and into leather play, or he's definitely dates white women. Like that kind of shit.
Niggas would be like, yo, what's your sign? You'd be like, hello.
Just see you getting an Uber in a leather harness. You're like, makes sense. But like on a Tuesday. You're like, Jesus, it's 7 o'clock. I was like, I know. I'm running late.
You smoking a blood this man resin on the end of the shit. Dude, like, yeah. Like, oh, I ran out of weed. No, I didn't. Scrape. Shout out to weed. You know what I'm saying?
Have they come out with any new drugs lately?
Yeah, what was this shit? Croca? Was it Croca?
Nah, those are made up. That's not real.
For a while, the zombie joint.
Yeah, that's not. No, those aren't. Okay, we're talking about fun drugs, not drugs that make you rip your face off, or whatever.
Was it caca? Like just like some shit that makes.
Do these even sound like real drugs?
Yeah, I know.
When you played drug war on your BlackBerry, there was no caca.
No, it was definitely
when you bought your 4 or 5 and ran to Brooklyn to sell your Valium.
To sell your Valium. That shit was mad cheap. You gotta work your way up to heroin.
How do you get started on heroin?
Listen, I don't know.
Do you get a dope? Is it like the opioids, and then like you can't get the opioids anymore, so you start fucking with the dog food?
Let's call literally any freestyle artist. No, but I think that's what it is. Like niggas prescribe you like Percocet and Oxycontin and shit, and then you're like, oh, my prescription ran out, and then niggas are like,
nah, I'm not refilling it. Start fucking with the hot bags,
dog food.
There was a guy on 125th Street yesterday. Shout out to 125th Street. And he was doing the dope feed nod with his phone in his hand, Beats by Dre headphones on.
What?
And a book bag. He clearly was coming from work, but he had just gotten right. And he was doing, he did the full bend over.
Ooh, and I was standing there,
full bend over in front of the IHOP. So you know,
said, shit, bend over. Dog food.
And I was just watching him because I was like, you know, is someone going to steal his phone? Is someone going to take his Beats by? Does he need help? And after 2 minutes, I was like, nigga, I got places to go.
I'm like, fam, I can't.
You
got to
hurry this knot up, my nigga.
Fam, I can't sit here and watch you for 25
minutes.
Like,
yo, this is not the most intellectual show. Yeah. Like, my show comes out tonight, which is a lot better. But no, he did not fall. He didn't drop his phone. No one bought the other fiends respected him.
I guess
it's a fiend code. Like if I'm a fiend and you're a fiend and I see you nod out, I'm not gonna like take your chains.
It's like y'all got you gotta live.
If I nod out, I want you to take care of
you. Exactly.
Right?
It's the golden dope rule.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? The golden rule of hot bags.
Each one fiend one. Wow. Damn.
Yo. Niggas is fiend.
You know what's really cute though? Well, you see two dope fiends that are like friends.
Yeah.
Like, but, and especially if they're like black and white and shit. They're like, ah, yeah. and they get like a rock. And a,
come on, bro. Yo, come on. You're my nigga. You let me say that, right? Yeah, we're friends. Yeah.
Wow. It just dawned on me. Every dope. Basically, there's just mad versions of us as dope fiends. There are mad Bodega Boy dope fiends.
Absolutely.
And they are,
and that's what they fuck with us on. Cause that full Timon niggas is like, Papi, I love you, Papi.
I love you.
Yo, I feel so funny. You say everything I want to say. You know what I'm saying, Papi?
God. Them niggas is on Showtime, but a whole different type of Showtime.
Niggas is on Blow Time, nigga.
Niggas said, I have like, today I meet Devin Evans.
How do I look? Yo, look.
Look.
What about the scar? I keep don't picking at that. It. I keep picking at it.
Hey, we're on Showtime now. Hey, Brittany, you bitch. You be Julia. Ask me questions. They're going to have a title card written with feces. Nigga in the wild cheap motel, like,
yo,
room tone.
Oh shit, dog food boys.
Oh shit, nigga's like, I said room tone. I said room tone. Nigga's just like,
yo, you got it. You got it, puppy. It's sparking. It's sparking.
Oh shit.
Yo, shout out to niggas smoking grills. I never smoked grills in my life. I mean, I feel like I may have freebased.
I can't say that with 100% certainty.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
like I feel like it depends on what you consider crack. Like if you actually go and cop crack and what put it on
consider,
a crack,
what you consider crack?
If you cop, if all you right, go,
this congressional hearing is taking a turn.
If you go to a crack establishment, purchase crack, knowing that it is crack.
I feel like AOC had a congressional thing. I was like, first of all, a crack establishment is not where you purchase crack, Mr. Martinez. Where are you getting crack at?
Oh, crack house. I apologize.
Please use the vernacular used in the streets.
I apologize, madam.
Where are you purchasing your dope food at?
My dope food is being purchased at Mitchell Houses. I apologize for my transgressions. Like crack to me is like, yo, you copping crack, nigga. Right. You cop the red top, you put that shit in the glass dick, and you smoke that shit. Mm-hmm. I've thrown cocaine in the blunt before, you know what I'm saying? Because it's just listen, like, yo,
I sometimes got this, a nigga, you listen, know, you gotta get right. Sometimes fam, you gotta smoke a woo.
Nah, not even that, fam. It's like, yo, I had 10 bags, like off 7, these 3, I'm not getting on the train on because there's police on the train, and I'm wild paranoid. So I'm gonna just throw all of these in this blunt and see what happens.
All right. I can't condone that. Can't condone that at all. That's not.
Don't do that. Richard Pryor did that. He lit himself on fire.
But he also made funny movies. So
also that.
You know?
So maybe try it.
But that was back in the day where like SNL sketches where basically he'd be like chicken and then Bill someone else would be like nigger, like this is a sketch, what the fuck is this?
Yeah,
like Dan Aykroyd or some shit. Like,
I think we still have the cone head on. I'm and like, shit, they'd be like nigger,
like this did not age well at all. Yeah. Shout out to SNL. We're gonna be hosting next month. Yeah. The musical guest is Bjork.
Letter S, as in Sam, N as in Natalie, L as in Lafayette, because some people like to include an ampersand in between SNL, and that is completely incorrect.
Wait, did you just like spell it out like you were in the call center?
Yes.
S isn't.
You know why? Because I keep having to call in and tell the cops that my car's parked on the street, because there's no street parking. You have to park in your driveway or your garage.
Why don't you just run for office and change shit in Jersey?
I probably could win.
Because a lot of shit don't make no sense.
Yeah,
what's the deal with the not pumping your own gas? What's
that's just convenient.
To who?
That shit is just like super convenient in the winter. Because like you get out and they're like, "Yo, fam, what the fuck are you doing?"
But why can't you pump your own gas? Like, what's the?
I don't know. It's just a thing.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm not mad at it. You know what I'm saying? Because
yeah.
Like if you listen, there's, you know that gas station when you come off the thing, nope. The Deegan to get nope. To the fucking, and you on 149th over there, that's right around your way. You know what I'm saying?
The gas station 149th?
Not 149th, but you get off the Deegan,
uh-huh.
And it's like some flower shit. I remember everything by like buildings and graffiti, not mm-hmm. by actual streets. But there's like a florist or whatever, and then my man Cypher got a fill in there. You go up the block and there's like a big ass Hess. And
this is why they're never going to do a Bronx version of Waze, because these directions are so fucking convoluted.
Turn left at the Waze, at the Scythe tag.
But no, turn right here where Mero once smoked crack.
Yo, that fucking, what do you call it? That gas station is wild treacherous. And I wouldn't even want to be out there at 3 a.m. pumping my own gas, because niggas will get you out there, bro.
I mean, you know, Niggas gonna get you if it's your time.
You know what I'm saying?
Saying, you know, as long as you keep a good, honest heart and a good relationship with Christ, you should be okay. When I pump my gas, I just yell out, "I am protected by the blood of Jesus, Jesus, Jesus!" And everyone just leave you alone.
The Dominican nigga pull up with a machete, like,
"Shut up, my nigga, shut up.
Give me your fucking wallet. I see you on Showtime."
Jesus, Jesus. And I start throwing ketchup on myself. No, there's a gas station I go to all the time. It'd be like mad taxi drivers and shit.
Oh.
Cab drivers, because I said taxi drivers like it's 1980. Like it's
You talking to me?
Hey. But that gas station, wild, because that's where they take their breaks, and that gas station owner lets them use the bathroom, and they be in there talking wild about America and having arguments about shit. I'm just like, yo, I'm just trying to get my beer, yo.
Yeah, what I saw, man.
Because also that's where the, I think the 42 bus terminates or something, so the bus driver's coming in and play lotto. So you can't buy beer at like 7 p.m. because every black person in the Bronx is buying lotto tickets, which is a big scam. Y'all people need to stop.
Stop
buying lotto tickets. I used to buy lotto tickets. Let me tell you, you never win enough to justify buying lotto tickets.
Cause you like you, cause you'll hit a lick and win $500, and you'll be like,
I've never even won that much.
I won $500, cause my aunt won $1,500 one time. But I'm like, Titi, you've spent like $5,000 in lotto tickets this month.
Just this month. Like, just this month.
So you are not even breaking even.
And like, then like, your Powerball is 820 million. People are like, yo, I'm gonna play this time. It's like, well, why don't you play when it was 20 million? You had the same chances.
Your odds were, you know what I'm saying?
Like, if anything, you had better chances.
Better
right?
odds, you know what I'm saying? Because niggas ain't playing for no 20 million.
And the worst part is, at this gas station, the poppy always goes, oh, this is the lucky ticket, every time someone buys a ticket. So and I'm like, yo, y'all can't all have the lucky ticket.
Stop.
Y'all know that, right? What's wrong with y'all niggas?
Fucking wrong with y'all. Yo.
Hey, look, this nigga got money. Let's rob him. I was like, nah, that's not me. That's not me. That's Jesus on Showtime. That's not me.
Not me either.
Okay? I'm looking. I'm ashy now. Okay? Look at my sneakers. Since it's talking at the bottom.
Yo, we broke, baby.
I'm broke, baby. I'm pop. I don't got it.
I don't got it, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Then I hop in an SUV just to go get ramen.
You can order an Uber Excel to go 3 blocks.
Why are you making it hot? nothing funny because they always have like the cabs. Like, I went to 5th Street by the Trace. They were like, yo, you need a cab? And I'm just saying, I'm like,
No.
My app provides a car.
Yeah, sorry.
That does not have hypodermic needles in the back.
Also, yeah. Okay? Yeah. They're in the back and you're in the front.
Do you even have a license?
Yeah. Shouldn't it be, if you do have a license, shouldn't it be pasted into this bulletproof partition?
I'm calling the cops.
Yeah.
I call the cops, get my ass beat. whoa, you think you're a white woman? What are you doing?
Hey.
Whoa, you can't call the cops.
Hey, what's going on with you, pal?
So sad. Is there surgery where I could become a white woman?
Oh, that's man. Like, damn, I almost really ripped off the wild problematic.
Yeah, thank you. I know you did. Is there a movie? Should we make a movie about that?
Yeah, that you become a white woman?
I'll become a white woman to get into college.
Didn't they do the Michael Jackson movie already?
You're ignorant. You're ignorant.
Stop.
You're ignorant. Don't go climb a tree.
Stop.
Yeah, Scarlett Johansson can play me.
Yo,
how good would that movie be? Like, she just be in the hood of shit.
Is she popping? Like, what's the most popping? Annie Kendrick. What do we get Annie Kendrick to play?
Oh, like a Freaky Friday and Andrew Kent. We switch lives.
Yo.
Andrew Kennedy gotta like collect all my drug debts and shit.
Yo,
and she ride around with the big gun, the like big glizzy.
Halfway through the day, she's like, "Why do I have the overwhelming fucking urge to smoke marijuana? She's like, what's going on?"
She's like, "Yo, she's calling niggas like, yo, if the big drink has to come through,
yo,
you don't want that.
I'll tell you something, B.
You don't want that.
You know what I'm saying,
all right,
it's Kendrick and
You don't want to. You don't be. You don't want to come home. And Andrew Kendrick is sitting in the dark in your living room waiting for you.
5'2", mad menacing.
What's up?
You know what I'm saying?
You just hear her stacking the cups.
Yeah. And then you just hear her in the silence. You know what I'm saying? And you terrified. You urinate yourself.
Ah.
And she's like, "Ew, you peeing yourself
in front of your kids." Wow.
You can't sit with us. Was she a Mean Girl? She wasn't a Mean Girls. What the fuck am I talking about?
Kendrick.
Yeah, she wasn't a Mean Girls, right?
Nah, no. That was Lindsay Lohan and Rachel McAdams.
Wow, McAdams.
That's a don't forget Lizzie Kaplan, who was the mean girl.
Oh, actually,
she trained Lindsay Lohan.
Didn't she die?
Nah, she was in Party Down.
Yo, when you said Lizzie Catman, I thought you meant Lizzie Grubman, the shorty that ran mad people over and just skated.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Shout out to her. Shout she was a PR her. Person.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yo, take note, Sherry. Okay?
Yeah, catch a body,
yo,
Sherry.
Catch a body for the gang, Sherry. You know what I'm saying?
In the Benz SUV. Mm-hmm. Please.
Lizzie
Don't
Grubman.
Embarrass me in the
sportage. Yo, okay. She did 38. She did 38 days in jail.
Wow.
How many people think she injured?
Wow.
Three.
Wow.
16.
Wow. Woo. Wow.
It was at a, was it in the Hamptons?
It was.
It was in the Hamptons.
It was.
Of course. I'm like, I could have said.
Security guards asked her to remove her Mercedes from a fire lane. She intentionally drove her father's Mercedes to a crowd of people outside of the Conscious Point Inn in the Hamptons, injuring 16 people.
You know what's better than driving your Mercedes into 16 people? Driving your father's Mercedes.
Yeah.
To 16 people. What a rich. Let me stop right there.
Wow. You know what she said before she ran him over? Fuck you. Fuck you, white trash. Later, allegations arose that she received special treatment at the hands of the police who did not perform a breathalyzer.
Wow! She's like, yo!
Wow.
Was this like femdom or something?
Yo! Wow, that's crazy!
That's wow.
Nigga said breathalyzer.
Stupid, I'm not gonna let you get the chance.
Damn. They had her with 26 counts.
Damn!
She was 68 years, but only got 38 days in jail.
Yo, shout out to fucking Chrissy Yakubi Gucci over here.
Did she get out on good behavior or something? Because did she even serve all 38?
God,
she served all 38, and they said that was enough, and she got like 5 years probation. Which is, listen, probation ain't shit unless you live in a wildlife. Then
probation
increase
serious.
Up our ability.
Yeah.
Like if you're just a normal person.
You're good on probation.
You can forget about it. If you out there wilding, probation will catch you on your ass.
If you're a shirtless Hennessy drinker,
that's how Meek Mill got caught.
Yes, sir.
Dirt bike, probation.
You know what I'm saying? Bike on 12 o'clock, nigga, went behind the fucking box.
We getting dirt bikes this summer, though?
Nah.
Hell yeah.
Nah, we got to get the those four-wheel ones that the old black people drive.
The ATVs?
Not ATVs.
The T-Rex shits?
Like the T-Rex shits. Oh, the niggas in the hood that get money, they drive.
And
you're like, damn, this car don't make no sense at all. But
like this shit is kind of like the same size of a car, so it's hard to park.
It's like a motorcycle car.
It's a tricycle motorcycle.
Let me put on my reading glasses and look this up.
It's literally a tricycle motorcycle.
Yeah.
But it's like more, I think it's two passenger.
Yeah, the poreless, the slingshot is a three-wheeled, you know what I'm saying? It's like a three-wheeled car, you know what I mean? Nah, I think, you know what? We should all get like one Tesla.
One Tesla?
Just get one Tesla and just share it like the episode of Martin.
I just borrow my neighbors and shit and bring it back. He's like, you leave Dutch guts in my Tesla. I think that was Jesus.
I'm running mad electrical cords to your neighbor's house and shit. I'm like, yo, I don't this shit gonna charge up your electricity, but I don't want you to fuck that shit.
Come on,
plug that shit in, all that lights dim. Like, it's just 50 minutes, y'all.
He told me, he was like, yo, it takes 24 hours to charge this shit on a house connection. I was like, god damn.
Yeah, I mean, what are you, a broke boy? Why are you charging it on a house connection?
Install
the Tesla charger in your house.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if I had a Tesla, I would.
Well, I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? Even the website is like, you know, house? You using a house?
It's like, nah, you're doing the wrong thing, baby. You don't even got a surge arrest.
You got to go to the supercharger. The superchargers will fix you up in half an hour.
Half an hour?
You'll be good to go. Okay. Good to go.
Okay.
But I don't really need a Tesla. I got Uber. Uber's making more sense.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be parking shit. And then, like, if you hit someone, you gotta get out and, like, pay for the shit. Oh, wow, sorry.
Wow,
that was your only kid? Damn, I feel bad.
All right,
Victor, cut them a check.
Okay, sorry. Matter of fact, here's $500. I'll give you something.
Damn, that's sad because she was kind of hot. I didn't mean for her to die. I want to get to that point where the car just crashes with niggas and you just come out with your checkbook, like,
here, nigga, go.
Do niggas still carry around checkbooks?
I don't have one in my drawer.
Everyone has a drawer. I have that and some stamps. I don't know when I'm ever going to use them, but they're just there for the emergency.
I also have paper clips that I'm never probably ever going to use.
I have a fresh bottle of Whiteout.
Wow. I got two rolls of scotch tape in a box.
The only thing I could think of to use Whiteout for is like writing on stunner shades. So would your boy tell him?
Yeah!
Like, what do you, am I going to white out a PDF?
I just put it on my computer. Fuck, bro. I shouldn't have smoked that weed.
Yeah, my MacBook is actually almost full, so I guess I got to throw it away and get a new one. Is that how it works?
Start from scratch?
Yeah.
I mean, pretty much, yeah.
But then you look at what you have saved, and it's just like, I'm a digital hoarder. So I just have like a folder of just memes.
So just get a terabyte drive and dump it all on there.
Nah, because then that's like, that's not, then you got to like connect it to this. And blah, blah, like, I want it all on one thing. You know what it mostly is? Yeah. It's downloaded Pino from when we go to hotels that have shitty Wi-Fi connections.
That's why the, you know, the MacBook that has a stupid touch bar up top, and it was like the new model or whatever. Yeah, yeah. When I went to get my laptop, the guy was like, yo, listen, fam. Like, what are you really going to do with this? And I was like, my nigga, can I keep it 100 with you since
we're
your fam? Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm watching Pino, and might fuck around and download Fruity Loops, which would cause me to download Bootcamp, which will probably crash any other computer. So I need, like, maximum processing power, and I don't need none of these emojis on my touchpad. And he was like, I got you, B. And then he got me, like, the latest model of the last model.
Right.
And that shit is, whew. I still got hella gigs on that shit.
Now, you're not Pinoing it like me, nigga. I got the Library of Congress on here. Okay, I got my nigga. Do you sort your porn by metadata?
No. You gotta do a fucking fuck sneaker shopping. You gotta do a Pino shopping.
Oh, we gonna do that.
Bring people. He's like, so what do you think is like your hardest, like most rare Pino scene that you have?
I was like, yo, this is dead stock Midori, like, shit.
Then it's just like, pshing graphic, dead stock Midori, valued at $250,000.
No, what we're going to do, we're just going to interview celebrities and we'll ask them what their favorite Pino scene is, and we watch it with them. We're going to do that with Issa Rae's coming on the show. If you listed, find your favorite Pino scene,
and then we're
going to watch it with you.
You know what I'm saying?
And then the thing is, we don't have to, well, Showtime, we can actually show it in the corner, we can just like pixelate it, and we're going to be on a camera, on the couch watching it. We get high.
You know what I'm saying?
Niggas get high and watch Pino with niggas. That's the name of our show.
Get high watching Pino.
Niggas, you see the new episode of Niggas Get High and Watch Pino with niggas?
What was dude's name? Lawrence, though? End of season one.
Yeah, Lawrence.
I'd be curious to see what she chooses.
Yes.
I think it'll be very classy, but very classy.
Impactful. Actually, what I found is
it'll be porn for women.
Porn. No. See, that's what you guys think.
Well, the whole camera
everyone gonna thinks it's going to be some nasty pumper. Shit. Some shit, though. You can see the track marks and shit.
Oh, boy.
Shorty keep her Jordans on.
Gate Master 8.
Every now and then you can see the cameraman in the background. Okay. You want that kind of Pino?
Niggas is using Gape gloves.
You want the Pino? You want the Pino where one of the performers stops halfway through and is like, yo, someone shut that dog the fuck up. You want Pino with niggas throwing up gang signs when they nut? Like, Crenshaw, nigga. Nigga crip walk to the pussy.
Show this game smash. You got a ski mask on? And like,
yo, I got charges. Don't show my face. Sure to get mad when nigga come on her face and show that shit, like just pouting like a child, pouting like a kid, like hurry up,
y'all. Why you fucking hurry up? My face, nigga. Ew.
That first drop hits her. She's like, it's like she's playing dodgeball. She's like,
ew. She'll be on the island, like.
She do that look up, like nigga, you finished, like. Ain't gonna be no BTS interview now.
No. She's in the shower. She's going home.
She's mad. Throwing all her stuff in her Louis Vuitton bag and get back on the bus. Woo! Shout to Muck Studios. We got lighters, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? We out here.
Lighters.
I think that's a little.
Don't forget, we're bringing. Well, it's not gonna help y'all because by the time this comes out, we'll happen again. But the Benevolent Boys are back. You know what
that's
I mean?
That's right. We out here.
Bringing back Bodega Bucks.
1 p.m. today.
Because of Cash
App.
Well,
not today. Friday.
Well, Friday it happened. Friday, yeah. So shout out to all the winners that got their money.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to you.
We're not allowed legally to say how much money we're giving away, but we are giving away enough money to buy 9 Bugattis.
You feel me? We out here.
But not a market value.
Okay. You get a used Bugatti. Woke up and used Bugatti. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think you'd be that amped to wake up in a used Bugatti.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like you wake up, you was like, man, amped. You start, they're like, oh, sir, this has flood damage. Yeah. The transmission's about to go.
There's 6 Newports in the ashtray.
Yeah, like, someone smoked inside, so the value's gone.
Yeah.
Imagine that's your everyday car, a used Bugatti and shit.
You pick up a kid from school in a Bugatti.
You got to go to the fucking Stop and Shop in a Bugatti and shit.
You got
to
get gas every 13 minutes.
You go to City Island and shit. Niggas like, oh, I know you tipping. You're like, I'm parking on the street. Fuck it. Take you 10 minutes to do a fucking U-turn. Shit, man. I'm trying. It's a big car.
Stop, yo, come on, man. Yo, stop.
Relax.
I'm just fucking trying to do you, pop.
They got mad French fries under the seat.
White Castle boxes. Yo, they can open the glove boxes, just mad Dunkin' Donuts napkins.
The rear, one of the rear headlights is out, so you just got like red tape on like, the back and shit.
You know what I'm saying? For
some... Nigga, fuck the door up, go to the scrapyard, just nigga, get a red.
Like,
nigga, just get like a tan Camry door and replace the shit with mad WD-40 on the side.
Yo, yo, that's a Tercel fucking tail light.
It fits.
You right.
It fits.
You got, I mean, you got a Bugatti, so I mean, I can't really say shit. I'm on a six train.
They got the little family stickers on the side. It's like two parents, four kids, and two guns.
Half a brick. Half a brick on a smiley face and a tail. Like, is that a cat? No, that's half a brick of heroin, nigga. Fuck out of here.
How much is a used Bugatti? Wow, near me. I didn't say all that.
Let's find out.
Oh, 1.2 mil?
Oh, that's nothing.
For 08?
Oh, wow. That's not a big deal.
That seems very wasteful. That seems very wasteful. You get a...
$1 million?
For 900, you get a 06.
For 900, that's you get a 2006 Bugatti?
If you would like to drive your family around one at a time... Like, yo, fam, we're going to dinner. I'll be back. I'm making six trips.
There's absolutely no point in having that car than other than to park it in the driveway.
Well,
or like on the street.
Yeah, you could do a lot more with a mil than 1.2 mil. You could,
fam, you could buy
a buy a ground round.
You could buy a fucking Benz that flies.
Yeah,
for $1 million. Like, what are you niggas doing? And Bugatti's probably gonna be played out in like a year.
You know what the thing is? I don't think Bugatti could be played out. I think maybe Twitter will say Bugatti's played out.
It's not like
ain't my girl. If I pull up in a Bugatti, ain't gonna be like, that shit is whack, nigga. Like, nah. That's probably, you don't hear comments like that.
I mean, if you were around some broke niggas. But it's not like timeless. Like a you know what I'm saying? You pull up in a Rolls Royce, niggas be like, oh, this nigga pulled up in a Rolls Royce.
You know the only timeless cars are Dodge Chargers and the 300 Chrysler that looks like a Bentley. I'm sorry. These are the rules. These are the hood rules apply. Because you can pull up in either
and
one of those.
PC Cruiser.
And people be like, oh, them shits is clean, boy.
PC Cruiser, you can't pull up in that Dick Tracy whip.
You haven't. The PT. Shout out to. Apparently, there's Bodega Hive members that got PT Cruisers. So shout out to y'all. Y'all still out here.
You're still out here, yo. Rep reset.
Driving those fucking hearse for ventriloquist dummies.
Man, Shane. Man, I'm going to go to McDonald's. Get a 4 for $4, Shane.
Do you remember the Pontiac Aztec?
Oh, yeah. Wow.
It was like, yo, you like camping? Can we put a tent in your fucking car?
Ah, stupid. And we named it after some Mexican shit, but we spelled it wrong. Wow.
Do celebrities design cars? No.
No.
Should we get on that? We have to because you hate minivans.
I hate minivans.
We have to get a functional car for a big family like you.
Yeah.
Or for a nigga like me that likes to take risks.
Yeah.
So no airbags, no bumpers.
Facts.
It's a real nigga car. No seatbelts. Just hold on to shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just mad handles everywhere. Like, yo, son, yo.
Handles and like.
Yo, I'm about to hit this nigga, so hold on.
And we have like the inflatables or some shit.
Yeah. Like,
if
you don't not like real airbags.
Yeah.
Like put swimmies in the corners and shit, like just in case you hit your head.
Matter of fact, fuck all that. We're just going to take regular cars, take the airbags out, and sell them to like the Caribbean. Because that's how niggas going to drive it anyway.
That's how we doing it. Niggas don't need airbags. Right. If you drive a car in the Caribbean, like you are just like rolling the dice on your life. Like,
true. Matter of fact, instead of an airbag, it's going to be sponsored by Grace Spices.
Oh, yeah.
So it'll just be like a big powder of cock soup.
Word. Like, oh, you know what I'm saying? You get the collab money, you know what I'm saying? Get fucking little
You can pick a flavor. You can have adobo. You can have Sazon.
You know what I'm saying? Mix it up. You feel me? Nigga.
Like, I crashed, but I got a meal.
You crash it like the wild plate of a Fungo comes up. Like, I had to keep me nervous while the police arrive. They're not arriving
in the building.
Yeah. I was like, yeah, went this way.
Oh man,
young Patrick in the building, yo.
Young Patrick, the god.
You know what I'm saying? I was wild drunk. Nigga put an astronaut helmet on my head, yo. Word to the god, that fusion dance was all his doing.
Oh, I thought that really happened. I was like, what? I was like, what?
That's how nice my son is. You know what I'm saying?
Like, niggas put an astronaut hats on out here without telling me.
And a neon word?
Shout out to all my niggas out there on the Instagram. Every time a girl posts something, you'd be like, without me? She's like, yo, I'm at the hospital. My mom's is OD sick. You're like, without me?
Oh,
whoa. I'm in the bath with the without two. Me. Yeah. Nasty niggas. Shoot your shot.
Get it.
You gotta
do what you gotta do, bro. It's summertime, it's getting warm. So now is mating season. Mating season
it's
has
true.
Begun.
It's you true. Know what I'm
saying? First day of spring is mating season.
Get out there.
Do your thing. Listen, I can't participate, but I will coach you.
Listen.
You know what I'm saying?
He's living vicariously. He's like, yo, he wants you to win.
Win.
He wants you to win, no matter what.
Every damn time, I don't never give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? So
I actually don't know the words to that song. I don't think most people do.
Nobody does.
Everyone knows the win part, everything after
that's
that.
That's it.
And then, if someone held a gun to your head.
That's about it.
If someone held a gun to your head and told you you had to recite a DJ Khaled song perfectly, what song would you recite?
Wow. Shit. I don't know his catalog, but I'm fairly certain that he has a song called We the Best where he just says We the Best over and over. Yeah.
It sounds about right.
So I would definitely do that. There's like a 50-50 shot of me getting my brains blown out.
I mean, you had a good run.
You know what I'm saying?
You had an excellent run, and there's no need to stop it now. So, fuck it. To the top, right?
To the top.
To the tippy top.
I think we were actually going to look for DJ Khaled's song. I was like, don't do that.
No. Nobody needs to hear that.
We don't need to
also,
do that
would definitely
listeners.
Get like the podcast taken down. He seems like someone who searches for his his tracks.
Like the salsa dancer.
Assad, send that DMCA.
Yo, Assad. Yo, niggas use half an interpolation of my song.
Yo, Assad,
on they podcast.
Send that takedown notice.
That's clownery. You can't do that.
Has the piracy takedown notice come in yet?
I'm the best. Have the Bodega Boys vocals come in yet? You know what I'm saying? Mm-mm. What the fuck does Bank of America want? Let's find out.
This thing, no, that's not Bank of America.
Yeah, Bank of America.
That's a secret hole. TD Bank.
Oh, shit. Available balance is mad money, nigga. Ow, we out here.
You shouldn't bank with Bank of America. They do predatory loans to people of color.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah.
That's why I only have like my weed account there. Okay. I moved everything over to City National,
where a kid can't be a kid. Ta-da. City National is a weird bank because you go in there, they got no ATM. It seems like they're laundering money.
Yo, City National.
You go in there, they got no tellers, they got no ATM. Damn. And then you go, they're like, what do you want?
Every
I was like, I have an account here. They're like, no, you don't.
No, you don't.
They was like, go outside.
Go stand outside.
I was like, what do you? I was like, no,
sir,
look.
This is not daytime.
It's not that type of bank.
That's not what we do here.
They're like, it's not that type of bank. Wink, wink. Get out of here. Amscree.
Beat it.
Like, what?
You're like,
you walk in, everyone like stops what they're doing, put their hand on their like, what's going on?
We're just
doing total normally bank shit.
Just banking.
You just hear like a panda groaning in the back, like, and they're like, nah, I didn't see that. Oh, wow. It's bring your dog to work day.
Yeah. Did it leave you?
I'm like, does that say the bricks room?
Yo, shout out
in there, mad niggas is bagging up and shit. I'm like, he's like, yeah, I mean, if you sign this paper, you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I think City National is a great bank.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should definitely go with them. There's only one branch in the entire continental United States.
They have an app, but
shout out to the app.
The app is,
that I have not downloaded.
The app is a lot. And the app sometimes some of the options. They'll be like, how do you want to do? Would you like this money in U.S. currency, European currency, Bitcoin, or bricks? And I was like,
what?
I was like,
what? Like, oh shit, fucking bricks.
And I was like, bricks. And it was, and like a voice came out like, why are you making it hot? What do you gain from this?
You should have written t-shirts in the other section.
This is episode 153, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Nigga, we out here.
153.
Yo, shout out to City National Bank, yo. That just sounds like every like default fake bank in every video game.
Yes. And that's the bank you rob. And, like,
Ramirez, they're robbing the bank. You have to hold it down. You get there, it's like City National Bank.
City National Bank.
Spider-Man swinging through there like, yo.
Hey, Spidey. You can web somebody and like scrap the bag of money for them.
Why get robbed every fucking episode?
Oh, man. Yo, it's been episode 153. You know what it is.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
It's your boy, DJ Nice, aka Young Chipotle, aka Pocket State Fat Like Tyrio, aka Pocket State Fat Like, here we go.
Woo.
Yeah, kids love it.
They do.
Still Chris Stass, Crystalline Dick, Slow Banana, I Know You Bitch, Young Gay Party, Young Hot Take, DJ Fuego, Mr. Nando's with a Rando.
Yo, don't pull up. You might get embarrassed.
Enjoy that chicken. 1994 and Nueva York.
Yeah.
Mikel going off the Juve boss. MC Lugan Goompi pulling up from 40. What's your shorty? AKA, don't talk to me in Uber pool. I don't know you. Also, I'm not in Uber pool because I have diamond status in Uber.
Yeah.
That apparently doesn't matter. It's some sort of scam Uber's running, but you. Yeah, you got me.
There you go.
You got me.
Uber just hit you like, you're my diamond girl.
No. They're basically rewarding you for using Uber more, but they're trying to trick you into using Uber more. I'm like,
yo, you use Uber so much that we get you to use Uber some more.
It's like, relax.
Like, I don't doubt exhibit.
It's like when you
CEO of Uber.
When you buy too much drugs and they start giving you it for free, you're like, all right, I might got to check my life.
I might have a problem.
The original of my plus one got plus one, so don't make a fuss, son. These are Rossi and Jamaican Jew. Jermaine Avocado Cool. Jung Pa, the Goose Mufasa. Young Chuck Cooney without the Cooney, a.k.a. Chili Limon, left handed reliever for the Yankees. Get okay, happily opening day.
Hey, Papi, we're going to spend it on Diamond.
You know what it is? We're going 163 and 0, and I know there's only 162 games, but, you know, I play a little afterwards.
Yeah.
Three Phone Jones, D-Zack Mackinac, Jake Chuckles, Stanley Cups, the human Dr. Bonner's label, Dilute, and a third time, Dilute.
Woo!
Also, if you take off the top of the Dr. Bonner's, the Dr. Bonner's is so thick.
Yeah, you can't even.
You gotta
stick
like
a finger in
put
it.
The Q-tip in and clean the little
wild
hole.
Three dollars this time.
Yeah, Dear Not a Trap, Mr. 240, because I like my Pinot blurry and not being able to tell if the performers possibly died. And you Google it and you're like, damn,
shit, damn,
wow,
R.I.P. Charlotte Styles.
Wow,
damn.
Shout out to Capri Styles too.
Damn, fuck. Wow. Oh, she dead too?
Who?
Capri Styles?
I don't think. Oh no,
that'd be mad sad. She had the wild, unfortunate butt tattoo.
Capri Styles.
She got like the Akuma Raging Demon shit tattooed on both her cheeks.
Oh, no, she's still alive.
Oh, shout out to her.
Wow, Google's is messy as fuck. I don't need to know her spouse's name.
Wow!
Like, my nigga.
Yo! Chill! They put that nigga on Blastoise.
All right. Oh, yeah, I see the tattoo. Oh, this nigga blowing that shit up. She called away. Wow!
Wow!
Wow! Wow! Wow, wasn't ready for all that. DJ Woolite, aka you listen to Wash FM.
Yeah.
All right, I got a special one for y'all. Oh, do y'all remember?
Let's hear it. Oh. Yeah.
A little. When you're living
in the hood, just because my pants are sagging doesn't mean I'm up to yo, I'm an accidental racist. Know me. Oh. I really wish you would. Yo. Now my chains are gold, but I'm still misunderstood. Wasn't there when Sherman's march turned the south into firewood. Wow. I want you to get paid, but be a slave I never could. Feel
like a newfangled jangle dodging invisible. Oh, wow.
Brother, this guy stinks!
Yo, what was your man LO going through?
Yo, I don't even
LO,
know.
LO, you didn't have, like, LO, I don't know what the bills were. There was no reason for you to do that song with Brad Paisley.
Brad Paisley!
Like, what did you buy with that?
That's
how big was the check? What did you gain from that?
Yo, fam. Like, the ridicule of the black community. That's all you
That's
got.
A shame. And see, because now they don't respect actual country music. So, you know, we're going to quick shout out to the greatest country
shit.
Song right now.
Yeah, it is the number one country song ever. Lean all in my blood. She did on my baby. You can go and ask.
My life is a movie. Bull riding and boo. Cowboy hat. See? Woo. Little Nas X, they took him off the...
Country trap.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They took him off the billboard because it was country, but, you know, it wasn't the right type of country.
Oh, I see what y'all did.
You know what it is.
Trap tree. Don't...
Shame.
Y'all don't fuck with the trap tree.
It's a shame. Also, remember they did that to Beyonce's country ass song. Remember this?
Yup.
This is a fucking country song. It's a racism.
Wow.
So the Bodega Boys,
haters.
We gotta come up with
a country song. Let's just do Cotton Eye Joe.
Where did you come from? Where did you go?
Where did you go?
I don't even think Cotton Eye Joe is a country song. I don't. I think
it's by the Rednecks.
Wow. We could do something. Cotton Eye Joe. Cotton Eye Yesenia.
Where did you go?
Y'all niggas stupid.
Where did you come from? Where did you go, motherfucker?
The curry goat, these spices, Jamal Hasler on the Bronx, and Dion, the Ray nephew's nephew, the Moreno, you can't contain it. The human meme, where the jaw, young Aaron, the racist provocateur, Henrik Budkos, Nelson Bang, Della, Sergio, can't see me, Vladimir Buffin, the human world is melting in your mouth, Mr. Bexon, Decatur, Ricky Tiki Squari, Greg Popovich, Morrissey, Rich Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maggie B, I got the cucumber, the juice is oppressed, but your boy never is. I am the art, damn it, the Dun Dada Ganoush, no more cup of noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fashion Nova, Casanova, we make sense, $5, $10, $10, $10. Forget the small change, give me
big money. Why?
Yeah. The only anthem I salute is Dip Set. Second, right. Catch me at square one, top left man says, what?
Yo, Marv, yo.
Chill Rizzuto, holy cow.
Goddamn.
We just saw punks all do is count checks and jerk off. That's, we got right. OJ, Purple Soft Soda, and it's me,
hey.
Sunny.
Oh, hey.
I'm back here.
Yay.
David Yerman, these expensive, these red bottles, these bloody shoes. Joaquin Noah, Andrew Kuhn, and aka the energy, the junior energy god, Junior. Come sit down, pardon me, Charger.
Sit upon it.
Call me Petco, because I got your bitch on freeze. The topic of gossip is Sciasis. Shout out to the 11791.
Billy Joe Gang.
Aka Grandpa Joe, because when you see Charlie, you see me, don't touch that golden ticket. Woo. Your man, Dead IDs, is more than the sheriff. Mind if I steal Instapot? I'm going to make my eggs in 5 minutes.
Ding!
Mr. Chopping that speed, bad music, I'm easy. Please believe in the black Asiatic. Crack your back like automatic craft mat. Mr. La Marina, Mess Marina, with a fresh misdemeanor and a cold demeanor. We're not giving up. La Marina will be open this summer.
That's right.
I don't care if I have to cut the gate myself.
They'll never take our marina!
Sheep mask killer, no one could be iller. The black Zach Morris, the poor Morris, a.k.a. the human Jerry Curl. Follow the drip.
Oh, shit.
A.k.a. your problematic bae.
It's smart.
It's not a secret family if you don't support them.
Yo, Alan.
Up next.
Coming to the plate, we have number 33.
God. Oh, my
Jay
God.
Martinez.
Oh, my God.
The Kid Mero.
What would your welcome music be?
Some wild, like, reggaeton shit just to make all the Connecticut people mad.
I respect it.
It's your boy, the Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Zero Flap, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, don't come in my DMs, bitch. I will embarrass you. A.k.a. Triz Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. skirt loader, jump the curb, hit your motherfucking Basenji, and keep it moving, nigga, because I do not care. A.k.a. I don't fucking baby, I fucking man, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? So coming up in this club with my shirt off, I don't give a fuck. A.k.a. no need to check the guest list. I am the guest list, motherfucker. I was putting some boot stunt voice in Shrek 3, nigga. That shit went straight to DVD, but fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Don't fucking touch me. Yo, Nate, shoot this fucking nigga's fucking wallet out of his pocket, B. Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? Where to Jerusalem? Yo, where to CC? You know what I'm saying? AKA CC DeBathia. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm doing dabs in my basement until I pass the fuck out. You know what I'm saying? AKA get into the shmoney and smoke. It's your boy Goldman Schmack. You know what I'm saying? And AKA, you probably ain't noticed, you know what I'm saying, because we went so handily, but Mero Jr., Mero 3, and Mero the 4th were playing the outfield in the later innings of the Yankees opening day game, which we won handily.
Ooh.
Against the bum-ass Orioles, you know what I'm saying? Because you know why? Because I'm the fucking dad of the year, AKA Big Smack Beyond Boy, AKA D.A. Yo Maradona, AKA Digging Your Big Putobo, you know, coming this pussy no more, okay? A.K.A. David Trisdale, nigga. Pow, pow, take that for data. You know what I'm saying? Give me that fucking pick, nigga. Give me Zion or give me death, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
I like that energy. You know I like
you know
that energy.
Need that.
Print the t-shirt.
You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Bartle's antenna so smooth. I fall asleep at the wheel and crash the zip car. I don't even care. It was a C-class, nigga. I got that. You know what I'm saying? Light work. A.K.A. Dominican Dada Dagman Daddy. A.K.A. Swipe my card again. There's definitely money on it. Don't make me embarrass you in front of your management when he come up here and ask for quick selfies and ask me how Heather and the kids are doing. Okay? Steven? You know what I'm saying? You like your little Stop and Shop cashier job, Barry? Huh? Huh? Stupid? You know what I'm saying? Then put the fucking honest tea in the bag and keep it moving, dog. And use my reusable bags because I care about the environment in the future. I'm down with the Green New Deal, nigga. We getting political. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Romeo Santos. Tu favorito, mami. I'm so zanny. I lick your titties eyelids very sexy on stage. You know what I'm saying? In front of you niggas. I don't care. I got Chelsea boots, nigga. So hook off. I dare you. I'll stomp you the fuck out. Stop it. My shit got elastic on the side.
Woo.
You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Lightnail Dutchie. Hello. Is it weed you're looking for?
Hit them notes, my nigga.
I can see it in your eyes that you're broke ass ain't got fire. So get the fuck up out of here, you know what I'm saying? Because I was just telling Chief in the car, niggas used to smoke tray bags from Simpson, but we off that. We cop pounds or better. You know what I'm saying? Allegedly.
a.k.a. Tom Brady. I got my balls deflated more than the football I use in the playoffs, plus Robert Kraft's balls combined. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Phil deGrasse Tyson, consensually. You feel me? I want to explore your cosmos, ma, with your permission.
With consent.
You know
what I'm saying? Yes.
Exactly. A.k.a. Lil Snoozy Vert, first nigga to tap out on live, nigga. I did it before Dex. By the way, somebody check on that nigga because he looks hurt. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Fried on Messi, MVP of Gelato. Let me adjust my motherfucking headphones, nigga.
Uh-oh.
A.k.a. Zaniel Bettyfield, you know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Joe Hooker. I dare you to smog with me.
Where?
At Mama Sushi. You know what I'm saying? The flagship where P.O. got his illustrious beginnings. You know what I'm saying?
Drop a pen. We'll come through.
Yeah. A.k.a. Ben Boston. My hands are gifted. I've given up on neurosurgery. You know what I'm saying? I am the only nigga in the Trump cabinet chilling. All these Yakubs are going down like diseased cows that escaped a slaughterhouse.
He's still out there, right? Ben Boston is still chilling.
I'm still out here. I'm still out here cooking, motherfucker. Candy whipping my yams. You know what I'm saying? She got them Kershey nip kiss, fucking kiss nipples, baby.
Ooh, them big joints.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Big brown joints. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I'm a nasty nigga.
Ooh, you sucking on them shits? Yeah.
Oh, yes, baby.
Ben, you all right. Yeah, you a freaky, you know, nigga. I know you be using them gifted hands.
You
right?
Already know, woo, baby. You know what I'm saying? These glasses is for looking at that pussy, baby. One time for your mind. Hey. A.K.A. open your fucking mattress in the cabinet, nigga, because you know who it is. It's the Zen Man. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Rico Sabrosa. A.K.A. Lucius lying ass nigga, man. Come on. Listen, man. I ain't take $20 out your purse, baby. I love you, man. Why would I have to do that, man? I was in hustle and flow with the perm. Man, I want an Oscar. I have money, baby. Come on now, man. You know what I'm saying? I also have a dream catcher do-rag that's worth more than $20. Come on now. A.K.A. Baby Newport 245. A.K.A. Nino Brown, shut the car down. A.K.A. live from the Burnside Avenue station of the 4 train, continuing the Tremont tour, performing for a six-pack of laser, is the East Tremont Stevie B, doing all his greatest hits like I wanna be the one your D.D. is bugging, and don't seek love, don't let me lean until I fall on the tracks and perish.
You know, sir, you're too close to the yellow line.
No,
get back.
I'm sorry. Oh, my God. Thank
sir,
you.
Get back.
You saved my life. You're my diamond Jesus. Oh, a diamond Jesus. A.K.A., you know what I'm saying? Listen, it's episode 153, so you are very well aware of the fact that there's no more rock stars left, man. It's only two of which I am one. The plantain supernova in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Tremont with a fronto in my anal Jessica.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? I always got to be prepared. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. I met my friend since I'm never going to fail. A.K.A. chilling at the crib off edibles, browsing tech socks, and making solid investments. It's Barmelo's Anthony
for three.
Swish in the mutual funds. Listen, man, if you see me at Target with my eyes redder than YG's entire wardrobe, dog, as I finishing a blunt, as I cross into the threshold, approach me like a fucking Earth sign mammal, nigga, because I meet react erratically. My cubs are trailing me. You know what I'm saying? So please fall back. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Hey, kids, it's Benzo the Clown.
Benzo.
Happy for your kids' party. I'll show up to your kids' party late. Ha-ha! After it's over, and for my grand finale, I'll fall asleep and pee on myself. You're not getting your deposit back, sucker. Peace. A.K.A. I sold fake lean to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. He's out of DayQuil gels that I hand-squeezed into a 2 liter of flat Fanta. And that's the niggas that you fuck with.
Oof.
Goddamn. A.K.A. Hasan tiene la pista, coño. ¿Qué fue? Llegó el gente de FIFA. Tú sabes que loco conmigo. Yo no le paro a nada. No suelte tu jeva, que yo rapo más que una guira. Te la derriengo, mamá huevo. You know what I'm saying? Muchos tienen dema, pero no son de nada. Bájale algo para no darte con el tumba coco. You know what I'm saying? Tengo pilas de caje muerto para pa la competencia. Tú sabes. Ponte cloro bleach, mamá huevo. A.K.A. Ya tú sabes que lo que. Shout out la casa, Shotan. Shout out casa. Y como siempre, shout out Lost Me. Y si tú no tienes cuarto, loco, quédate en tu fucking casa comiendo tuna fish. Mamá huevo. Shout out fucking Desus Night. Shout out Vito. Shout out Basti. Shout out Dewey Lee. Shout out Hasan. DJ Hasan es el coño más duro que pone la nota. Shout out Dímelo. Shout out Bloquete, Capitán. Y shout out mi presidente Pío. Secretario de Defensa. Y Quimero presente con el cañón. Me quité. Ya.
Episode 153, you know, the Bodega Boys in the building, live from the jam room. Shout out to Cash App. Shout out to Bodega Boys.
You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Bodega Hive in the building, you know what it is. Shout out to Showtime. Make sure to check us out, you know what it is. 11 p.m. on Thursday, or if you're mad smack, watch it on Saturday. Oh. Matter of fact, watch it every time it's on, because every time you watch it on, it's a vote for us.
That's right. You know what I'm saying?
We got to go make some more content, some work, because you know we're the hardest working boys in the industry.
That's right.
We out.
Peace.